Hi, welcome to my new video. We are outside today because this is the only spot where I have kind of good light. We are making nesting dolls today in the shape of a penguin because my daughter really loves matryoshkas. Izvinitsi pashalusta, any Russians out there? And she really loves penguins, so I thought let's combine these two and make penguin nesting dolls. So, to start, we need nesting dolls, of course, because I'm not skilled enough to actually make them myself. We are only painting them today. I ordered these on a website for Russian souvenirs. They're really good quality, I'm really happy with them. I first kind of mapped out the shape of the penguin. I'm drawing only half of the penguin and then I'm folding the paper in the middle to make a symmetric shape and I'm cutting it out. Now I'm checking if the shape fits and then I'm tracing everything onto the doll. And then I wanted to add wings. So I used the Dremel tool to make slits on the sides. Now I'm measuring where the wings will go and making sure that they are in the same position. Whoopsie daisy! Well, we're off to a great start. I'm hoping this wood doesn't crack on me. I'm following the line that I made with the pencil. And then I'm tracing that on the lowest setting of the Dremel tool. Just doing this really carefully. Take your time, guys, because you don't want the wood to splinter or anything. Now you can see me making the shape of the wings. Now I'm testing it out and adjusting it. And then mommy duty was calling, so I took a break. And then I'm tracing that onto some leather that I have left over from another project. But you can also use cardboard or something else. Baby girl was trying to sneak everything off the table. Then I'm squishing in the fabric, or leather in my case, and making sure it fits and looks nice. And my daughter was already saying wow wow because that's how she calls penguins, so she already knows, I think. In the end I will secure these with some hot glue. Okay, now we have our slits ready and now we can start painting. The nesting dolls come with a pencil marking and you should always make sure that they align perfectly, and that's why I traced it on the bottom as well so I can paint it and I will not lose the pencil marking. Clumsy me again, dropping things. And now it's just marking, painting, marking, painting. And then we have our base layer finished, all white, and then we can start with the actual penguin shape. I'm using a pencil to sketch out the part that I want black, and then I'm filling it in with some acrylic paint. For the last two, I changed it up a little bit. Penguin chicks are often a little lighter in color, so I used gray and added some details in black and some texture. And then I'm adding some detail with alcohol-based markers. One of my penguins is holding a little star and the other a little heart. So adorable. To map out the star, I just used the alcohol markers and then I used gold to fill it in. In the end, I gave all of them some red cheeks, because everything looks cuter with red cheeks. And then I added some feet. Final step, we are sealing the penguins. I'm using a Cllear water-based sealant. Next time I will put them on the box rather than in the box. That way you can also hit the feet. Learn from my mistakes, guys. Here are the finished penguins from Vogel. I hope to see you in the next video.